Hello all, I am Pallavi Bhujbal, working as an assistant professor in the Department of Computer Engineering at AISSMS Institute of Information Technology. Now today, in the last lecture, we have seen that data mining process, software development approaches. So today we will start with data mining process by using the CRISP approach here. So today we will see this approach here. That is the CRISP approach. So that CRISP approach has six steps. So we'll see this step one by one here. So now we will start with in 1998, a consortium of vendors and the users, including Daimler Chryslers, which is of SPSS and the NCR, proposed yet another approach also. So these approach claimed to be more practical, successful, and widely adopted model was there. So that is called the CRISP approach, CRISP data mining approach, for cross industry standard process for the data mining. So these process consist of six steps. In this, first is business understanding. We consider as a first step when we are starting our approach. Then the second is the data understanding. So we'll see this one by one, that data understand business understanding first, data understanding second step, data preparation is third step, four is modeling, fifth is evaluation, and the last one is the deployment. So these are the six steps when we are approaching our project in the data mining process. So we'll see these steps one by one here. So when we are start our approach, so there are lots of questions are comes in our mind. In that, first is, what are the aim of projects? Why we are preparing, creating that projects? What are the aim of actually our project? So these kind of questions are comes into the our mind. So determine the business object and assessing the current situation in the enterprises. The management can then define the project objectives as well as requirements. So this criteria for determining if the project has been a successful should also be clearly specified. So the management should also allocate a budget, perhaps only a preliminary budgets, and define the benefits expected from the project. So in that, there are some first task we have to follow in this business understanding. So first of all, we do some like clearly describe the project goal, including the outcomes expected, whatever we expecting our project, and preparing a report describing the business objectives here. So second task, if we want to follow in that, we are following the assess the project situation and the environment also. Here we explain the terminology that we'll use and produce a report listing the terminology in the business understanding here. A produce a project plan. The plan should include data mining goals, data mining success criteria, and the details of all tools and technology to be used here. So once all this task has been completed, the data mining task may begins with the data understanding process. So this is the second step, data understanding step we see here. So after fixing the all task in business understanding, we will go for the data understanding. So what the questions will come in our mind when preparing the data, when we are doing related to data here. So there are three questions are arrive in our mind. So what data needs to be collected, which kind of attributes are required, what is the data coming from, where is it, where is data coming from. So these lots of questions are coming in our mind when we are understanding our data, when we are preparing our approaches. So does the enterprises have a number of computer system that will need to be used to extract and integrate data? So these also questions are arise in our mind. So the data attributes should not be related closely. They should be independent. If they are not independent, their pre-processing of data should ensure that they are. So these data need to be loaded and integrated in order to successfully complete the data collections. Since the data may be collected from many different sources, the data is likely to be poor quality. Obviously, if we are collecting the data from the different sources, so they will get very poor quality data. So for that time, requiring the data pre-processing. So in that, data understanding also include the some steps. We have to follow the some steps when we are doing the data understanding. We collect the data and prepare an initial data collection reports. Second thing we'll do in the data understanding is describing the collected data and prepare a data description report. Exploring the data and preparing a data exploration report also. After that, we need to verify and qualify and prepare a data quality report also in these steps. After getting the clear data, pure data, we'll go for the next step. That such data is not conveniently available from one source, and the number of sources had to be used to collect the data in paper. So after getting that data, preparing that data, after understanding the data, which kind of attributes we are using here, from where our data is coming, from which resources we are collecting our data, we'll go for the third step, that is the data preparation. So this is the third step of our CRISP approach. So when we are preparing the data, after getting the data understanding phase has been completed, the data preparation phase can start, obviously. So data preparation is substantial task and may consume a much more time on that. 80% of our project time, if the data has been collected from the number of different resources. It means this step consuming more time, 80% of time we are spending on this step here. So data preparation is likely to include the filtering data, aggregation data, aggregated data, some data and filling of the missing values also. So it may also require the identification of outliners. Sometime maybe duplication records and the redundant data may need to be identified and eliminated from our data sources. So the outcome of the data preparation phase is the final data set. When we are preparing the data, we are removing the all kinds of redundancy of all kind of duplications here. So we'll get the final data at this stage. Once the data sources available are identified, during the understanding phase, the data need to be selected, clean, constructed, and formed into the describe form. So here, getting this all these things, we need follows some task at here: selecting the data, cleaning the data, construct data reports, then integrate our data for integration reports, and format the data. So all these steps we are including our data preparation when we are doing any project approach by using the data mining. So these are the steps which I included here. So the cleaning, integration, format, and the selection of data. So we'll go for the next step. After getting a final data, we'll go for the modeling, actual modeling. We start from the here. Yes, the fourth step is the modeling in our CRISP approach. So understanding of data is essential in identifying the data mining techniques to selecting or analyzing the prepared data set. The techniques obviously will depend on the business objectives of the project and the type of data has been collected. So last not but the least, model need to assemble carefully involving the stakeholders to make sure that created model meet the business objectives. So that time we need to follow some steps here in which we are generate a test design. So generate a test design and prepare a test design report. Then second is select modeling techniques and prepare report for the listing assumptions in which we are following the business model and select our parameters also After getting that, evaluate the model, prepare a report, describe the evaluations. So these are some steps we are following our modeling steps here. So after getting that, selecting, generating test designs, building model, evaluation the model, we preparing a report describing the evaluation, we getting a difficulty to identify an appropriate model since we have not yet studied the techniques. So that's our that are available to us. So after getting that all, we are going for the evaluation process, which is our fifth steps. So role of the fifth step is evaluation that has been done so far. So is the project likely to achieve the business objective here? Does the model have any deficiency? So lots of questions are coming at this stage. So is the model likely to produce useful result? And many more questions are coming. So these involves evaluating the model and reviewing the first four steps of model. Have all the important business issues been carefully considered? It may be possible to use some test data to evaluate the proposed model. So there are lots of steps we are following here. Some steps. In that, we are doing the review. In which we are doing the review the process and prepare a report that summarize the result of the reviews. Okay, next thing is evaluate the result, prepare a report, thoroughly reviews and the project and notes any deficiency here. So here determining, evaluating the result, preparing a report that thoroughly review the project and notes all the deficiency at this stage. So after determining this step, next step, and prepare a report that lists further actions and the reasons for each of these actions as well as how these actions may be implemented. So evaluation and the deployment, which is the next, our next step, are perhaps not applicable for the all datas which are applicable not for the first approach which I already explained, that our life cycle. So here, but in the CRISP approach we are using this step, evaluation and deployment. That's why it used from 1978. So once the evaluation is accepted by the management, the last step is deployment. So assuming the deployment is successful, it should be possible to generate a report of project, implement change in the process of the organization, implement a repeated data mining process. For this successful deployment, the consumer must understand the action to be carried out by the software. So this is our last step, deployment. In that we also including lots of steps like the plan deployment and produce a report, summarize the plan including how the plan is to be implemented. Then after getting that, produce the final report. Once the deployment has been successful, the project team should be complete a final report of our project. So this final report may be comprehensive report including all the report produced earlier. After that, review the project and documents, what went right and what went wrong, how the project could have been done better. So the report documenting experience of the team should be produced. So these are the six steps which we are including the CRISP model here. So this was our CRISP model data mining, which we are including these six steps: business understanding, data preparation, modeling, evaluation and the deployments. After getting all this, we'll go for the application of data mining in the next lecture. Thank you everyone. Thank you.